What up, y'all? How we doing? Let me know you're tuning in. Say hi in the chat. We're gonna continue building Omnimorphs. I'll bring them over here for a sec. Omnimorphs, these guys. We're building, the sandbox is putting on a contest, and we're building a weapon and a shield and armor for this collection. So I already put together the shield and the weapon, which was like a trident or a staff, on the last stream. And if we have time, I'm going to do the armor first, and then if we have time, we'll go back and we'll animate the staff and shield. If we run out of time, we'll just do that on the next stream. Which might be the case. We'll see. My back is already killing me. This might be just an hour one. I like to go for at least an hour, but sometimes we go 2 hours. But I don't know if I got it in me today. We'll see. But let's get going. Oops. I'm gonna get some inspiration here for what we want the armor to be. I like this. All right. Let's see here. Here yet? No. This is gonna be in stream. Why did I not call it stream? I'm gonna call this building. Yep. Sandbox. Omnimorphs. Oh, we don't have anything created yet. Building. Sandbox. Omnimorphs. Armor. Omnimorphs. And we are going to actually why can you see this? Or maybe you can. I feel like you're not supposed to be able to. Hide OBS windows. Apply. Okay. There. Now you can't. For sure. Let's get rid of all of this stuff. And what we need to do is get VoxEdit back open. Reset. Template, medium human, building, sandbox, omnimorphs. Let's actually go here. Gonna get this quick. Rid of that. Here. Armor. Omnimorphs. Boom. Alright. Now, since we really don't know what the Omnimorph's head is gonna look like. What should we do for the head? I don't think we need to. Oh. We don't need to build one, but we can. Should we just build an Omnimorph with armor? Sure. Let's do it. I'll be for it. I'm a little tired, but no biggie. Should have drank more matcha. A BRB. I'm back. Had something stuck in my tooth. I had to go get it out with some floss. I got hair on me. Alright. Let's build an Omnimorph here. We're just gonna make it. Probably one more. Yeah. For those of you that are curious, oh, I lost it. Where'd it go? I liked the one I was on. Do you want to find it if I bring it back here? There we go. This is who we're building. I actually. Let's get this color. Oops. Let's just do it all. Okay. Let's do just that. All right, that's good here. Then we are gonna build this. Get some colors. Thank you. Okay. Start here, and we're gonna build on top. That's too high, I think. Oop. I had a feeling I did that on accident. I feel like I gotta go even higher. Maybe that's what needs to happen. Come down one. I guess we can go with that. I don't know what, I just figured out a cool button. I don't know what this button is or when it got added, but if you press F, you can, like, say I'm like working way out here like I do sometimes and I want to get closer, just push F. And it kind of like centers it all up and gets it like at a good distance. The fuck? I wish I would have known this sooner. Or maybe it's new. I use a lot of my keyboard keys, which is why you don't see me clicking over here all the time. If you hover over them, they'll give you what the keyboard key is for each of them in the parentheses. So right now I'm pressing 1, 2, 3. 3, 4, and see it's 1, 2, 3, 4. And then this is R, T. I use R and T a lot. I'm assuming this is Y. Yep. So R, T, Y. And then this is I. And I don't use these two for hotkeys, but P and nothing for that one. Yeah. And then F. And I saw H brings up this. Does it say what F is? Focus camera. So you press H, you can bring up the keyboard shortcuts, and then you can see all the different shortcuts that are available via keyboard. I like to use the shortcuts, or the hotkeys. So that's cool. You don't have to even hover. So F, that's good to know. Because I catch myself all the time out here, like, because I want to get a decent distance away to like see it all sometimes, but then I just keep working and I'm like, where? I need to place it right here, but I can barely see. But then as soon as I realize that, I can just push F and boom, now I can see perfectly fine. That's dope. I wonder how long that's been a thing. I've been using VoxEdit since early 2021. And I just found that out, and it is February 24th, 2022. That's funny. I've been using VoxEdit since like January of 2021. Maybe it's new, or maybe I was just oblivious. I didn't know the H key was there either, so H and F are new to me. But I love F, focus camera. All right, this is what I'm attempting to do. Oops. Turn it there a little. This is what I'm going for as inspiration. It's, I love the detail of this, but sometimes, and a lot of collections are like this. It's hard to get the precise details, but you can kind of like take it, the general concept, and then translate it. At least that's what I try and do usually. You miss some things, but overall, that's this. I'll do some more different like shading and stuff here to make it look better, but. That's what we're doing. And let's do this. See, sometimes I use the buttons. Just depends on like where my headspace is, I think. Yeah, see, sometimes I just go straight over there. Ooh, it's gonna be wrong. And sometimes I just click, like I know I'm on the right row, but I'm not sure where. And then I can see where I am, and then I can just slide over or whatever I need to do. Because it doesn't really hurt if you push any of these buttons. Just moves, changes things. So now I know that when I hit this button, even though I'm not looking at the keyboard, I know if I wanted to hit erase, I just have to go one to the right. Or say I'm trying to, I know I'm in the general row of tools, which is the next row down on your keyboard, the QWERTY row. If I hit here, okay, now I know I'm on that button. If I was going for the, whatever this tool is called, the face tool, then I know I just have to move one button over so I can click with my next finger, and boom, Now I'm on the face tool, or one more over, and I can fill it in. You know, that's kind of how I do it a lot. And then to get to this, whatever the fuck, I don't know these tools by name, the picker tool, I just have this one memorized. It's I. So then I just look down and go click I. You'll get the hang of it. It speeds things up probably, but I mean, it's really not that hard to go over here and click, but it's I think it does speed things up because you're not constantly like taking your focus away. Especially once you memorize it and you just have your hands placed in a strategic way. Usually what I do is I put my ring finger, the one with the tattoo on it. I put my ring finger on 3. Is that what I do? Let me see. So I do. Yep. So I put my. So what I do. I'm trying to look and describe this precisely. What I do is I put my ring finger in between 3. The like divot in between 3 and 4 at the bottom, right above the letter E, kind of resting on E, and then my middle finger is on R, my T, or my pointer finger is on T, middle finger R, pointer finger T. So then I can switch between these two, which I use the most, with my two most like coordinated fingers, I would say. My pointer and my ring, or my pointer and my middle finger. And then with my ring finger on my left hand, I can switch between the paint, the eraser, and if I stretch it, I can also click to do the create mode to place the boxes. So yeah, that's kind of how I do it. I mean you could also slide over one. It's just I never use this really. I mean, it's, sometimes I do, but then I just go click on it. So I think having R and T, having this ability, is probably my favorite, and then followed closely by being able to switch between these. But the more you practice it and you keep your hands there, the better you get. So we're gonna go. Is that okay? No, we don't want black down there, I don't think. So let's do. Here. I definitely want a black ear, so we can just drag this. Boom. Yeah, I think that's how I would do it, for sure, that at least. Oh man, my old man back. I roll out with a foam roller like 5 times a day, just roll my back out, probably because I'm always hunching when I'm on the screen, and I'm on the screen a lot throughout the day. But I take a lot of breaks, stand up, do shit. I go for walks every once in a while. I want to get a walking, what's the fucking word I'm looking for? A treadmill. I want to get a treadmill that goes in front of my desk. And I also want to get it so I can raise it up and lower it down. Yeah, but those are all things that are coming. Do coming in the near future. Alright. So I like that. Now we're gonna start building. Need these colors now. Having a standing desk while I'm building is gonna be nice because I always like hunch over and then like leaning into the picture. if I sit back, I'm like too far away, so I had to like sit like this, and my back muscles just get tired, to be honest. Try and sit back for right now. How we doing? There's many of y'all are tuning in live. Say what's up. For catching the replay. Let me know you caught the replay. Let me know what you like about what I'm doing. Let me know if you want to see something different. Let me know if you want to see me build something specific. I love doing different things, so. This is for you guys. I mean, I'm going to be building no matter what, so I figure I might as well stream it while I build it. But if you guys have anything you want to see, let me know. Otherwise, I'll just keep on building what I'm going to be building anyways. Which I'm fine with, if that's what you guys want to see. I'm just opening it up. Y'all let me know. Open invite. Alright. That's the colors we need. I'm just like thinking about how I use my fingers now. I think how I explained it is how I use it, but I kind of just like move it all around. I just kind of like feel, and like I said, I look over real quick and I can see where it is, and I know if I need to move my hand up or down a little. You want to color those in. Wonder if we'll actually be able to do. Probably not. Do a stripe. And then we'll do that again. And then we'll do this. This one's gonna be thicker. At least one thicker, maybe two. Okay, let's try this. So, first we got this. Just follow it. wonder if we should do this. Whoops. Like that. And then let's get a little higher. Not that high though. Oh, we're too high. Well, we can make it bigger. Let's go. Why? Let's go 28. That would be plenty high. I could do that. This is gonna be some battle armor. So I'm thinking to myself here, sorry, I was silent. I think I want to make this a different color black. Although it's very similar. Yeah. You know what? Focus. I'm just trying to decide if I, maybe it'll help if I do this. Focus. Beautiful. You know what I'm gonna do here for a sec? change it to this color. So I'm making refresher. Now I'm just kind of giving them like they're, if you guys remember from the previous video, they're like a spirit or of some sort that has come to Earth and they're observing from afar. But so they blend into community or the society, but they wear masks and clothes that cover up like all their body basically. So like this top part is kind of like in my interpretation the spirit kind of like floating out. So I'm making like the wavy spiritness coming out of the head. And then I'm gonna give them these earrings and then the head will be done. That's gonna be too far out. Let's keep it just tight to the head. Focus. Yep, that looks cool. And you can like see that it's like got some stuff going on up there, but it's not too crazy. This isn't like exactly that, so it's more of a armor style is what I'm going with. But basically interpreting that piece into this. Let's turn it back up here. Yeah, I like that. Focus. All right, turn it black. Cool. That's pretty dope. Wonder. Texturing. Love it. It really adds to a piece. Takes more time, but really makes it pop. Pop. I really like it. I think we need to do one last. I can do too much. I think that's pretty dope. Damn. Alright, I spent a lot of time on the head tonight. I do that though. I love making the head look just right. I think we did a great job though. Patting myself on the back. That's a pretty dope armor interpretation of, let's pull it over, of that guy. I just like the general concept and then the colors, and now it's the piece of armor. I don't know if, oh, let's add the earrings. And then we can be done for tonight. Just so I can see. Switch back to this. My computer's getting super hot. It's been running all day. You can see it starting to get a little laggy. Thank you. Oh yeah. That is a dope ass helmet. Let's finish getting this color back to where it should be. Boom. Now let's see. You, yeah. I like it a lot. One last look. That's pretty. Alright, y'all. Hope you enjoyed. Thanks for catching the replay. I will see y'all on... What is today? Today's Thursday, so I got the weekend off. Friday, Saturday, Sunday off. Who knows, maybe I'll throw in a bonus stream here or there. But then I will be back on Monday. Monday playing sandbox games. And then Tuesdays and Thursdays I'll be building avatars and assets. So tune in, learn with me. I'll teach you as I go. Feel free to ask questions in the comments. I'll be checking them. And if you enjoy what I'm doing and you made it this far, make sure you like, subscribe, share it with a friend, do all that fun stuff. Appreciate y'all for being here. Take it easy.